Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel Website 360. I am Prof Govind Narayan Purohit, and I welcome you to my channel. If you have already subscribed to my channel, I am highly thankful to you. If you have not already subscribed, kindly do subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so that you receive the videos of notification of our videos very fast. Right? We have now started discussing about veterinary medicine, and we are discussing today an emergency problem, the acute ruminal tympany, and some of the new approaches which I could find out. Right? As you know all that acute ruminal tympany is an emergency, and one must know about it, one must treat the animal on a priority, and of course you should attend the case on a priority, right? Now, ruminal tympany is the excessive retention of gases of fermentation with abnormal distension of the rumen and the reticulum, and the gas may be in the free form or persistent foam mixed with the ruminal contents. So you can see here, this cow is having a distension of the left flank, basically more of the left flank, this one more of the left flank, and when the animal, because of this distension, animal is in great problem and may die very fast, right? Now, ruminal tympany has been described to be of two types, the frothy bloat or the primary ruminal tympany, and the free gas bloat, what is also known as the secondary ruminal tympany. Now, feeding of cows are let on pasture which have plenty of legumes, feeding on legume pastures which are wet, and feeding of finely ground grain, legume, vegetable crops. What this will cause? This will result into rapid degradation of the plant matter or carbohydrates and increase the encapsulated bacteria that produce the slime. The slime entraps gases of fermentation, and the rumen and reticulum start distending due to entrapment of the gas and development of more and more and more gas, and there will be a pressure on the lungs. The animal will have difficulty in respiration. The animal will try to relieve the pressure by kicking at the belly, and it will have respiratory distress. If this is not taken care of urgently, then the animal may die within 3 to 4 hours because of the pressure of the distended rumen on the diaphragm and ultimately on the lungs, resulting into asphyxial respiratory failure. Then free gas bloat occurs because of physical obstruction due to some foreign body in the esophagus, what we call the choke, the stenosis of the esophagus, or the pressure existing lesions outside the esophagus can cause narrowing of the esophageal lumen, and then it can result into inflammation of the rumen, and because the rumen cannot eructate the gases through the esophagus, so rumen start distending and animal feels pain. There will be similar signs, and the animal may die because of asphyxial respiratory failure. The clinical signs would be distension of the left side of the abdomen, difficulty in respiration, colic-like symptoms, and death within 3 to 4 hours if not treated. Animal may have frequent urination, sometimes it may have diarrhea, and animal may die, right? So it's an emergency condition, one should attend it on a priority, right? Now, this is how the ingesta in the rumen accumulates. The fine particles of high density settle on the bottom, then the liquid ingesta layer, medium density, and the layer of coarse hay and low density particles, which release a plenty of gases because of fermentation by the ruminal microflora, and there are gas pockets formed, and with the slime it entraps the gas, it goes on increasing, leading to distension, right? Sometimes questions are asked in your exams, the difference between frothy bloat and free gas bloat. Here is a table showing the differences. The frothy bloat is dietary in origin, whereas the free gas bloat occurs because of obstruction in the process of eructation. frothy gas bloat. It is frothy in nature, foam gas with bubbles in the rumen, and it is usually gaseous in nature. It is frothy is due to excessive production of gases of fermentation, and free gases due to failure of eructation of the gases. The onset is faster in frothy bloat, and free gas bloats the onset is slower. In acute distress, the animal may have symptoms such as frequent urination and defecation, labored breathing, restless movements. Okay. Then how to diagnose? You have to pass a stomach tube. The tube does not enter the rumen. There is some obstruction in the esophagus, that is choke. The tube enters the rumen. The gas is not relieved. It is frothy bloat. The gas is relieved. It is free gas bloat. Right. Diagnosis can also be made based on the symptoms, based on the distension of the rumen and the respiratory distress. These signs can give you some clue that the animal is having bloat, right? Now, there are some home remedies which have been practiced since very long times. That is the massaging the rumen, tying a stick in the mouth and making the animal to walk for at least half an hour. This will lead to belching and the release of the gases. A solution of sodium bicarbonate, cooking or baking soda and water has also been suggested. A small amount of kerosene, 50 ml in warm milk, has been suggested in documents of FAO. But many other published scientific materials show that this has little advantage over paraffin, which is a better pharmacologic agent to be used in bloat. Then a small amount of peanut, soya or linseed oil. A good option would be the small amount of turpentine oil, 50 to 100 ml dissolved in sweet oil, any edible oil, maybe soya oil, maybe peanut oil, maybe linseed oil. That will help in reducing the foam and release of the gas, release of the distension. Then 50 gram asafoetida with water or oil. Farmers have been giving this since very older times, and this can help. The treatment, the first treatment would be to remove the source. If you have let the cows on pasture, remove them from that pasture. And then passing a stomach tube is the best treatment for gassy bloat. Once the gas has been released, the cause of obstruction should be looked for, right? Then a field treatment which has been done since times immemorial, that is the passage of the trocar and cannula. You just have to rupture, make a vent in the center of the left paralumbar fossa, and this will relieve the bloat when a stomach tube has not worked. Sometimes clinicians use needles to puncture the rumen. Yes, maybe if you don't have a trocar, you can use a needle, but try to use a large bore needle, and then be careful because the ruminal movements are not decreased in ruminal bloat. So the rumen will be rotating like this, and your needle will also rotate. Sometimes it may injure the peritoneum and the ruminal wall. So one must be careful, right? Then surfactants like cimethicone can be given. They help in reducing the gas. Anti-foaming agents like non-toxic oil, non-biodegradable, 250 to 500 ml per animal. Detergents such as dioptyl sodium sulfosuccinate, 90 gram in 1 liter of water. Synthetic surfactants like polazoline at 25 to 50 gram are recommended. And there is one commercial preparation available over many countries, that is the bloat guard. One can use that. Alcohol ethoxylate 20 to 40 ml with water is more effective and faster than oil. And then intraruminal administration of anti-foaming agents have been used by many clinicians, and tetracycline intraruminal have been suggested by many clinicians that they will decrease the microflora causing a lot of gas. And then anti-allergics are suggested for bloat in ruminants due to histamine atony of the rumen, right? Then one can use polyethylene glycol for ruminal bloat, right? there was one publication in the Revista Columbia Gastroenterology in 2011 by Hernandez, and he summarized many of the drugs that can be used for bloating and abdominal distension. But most of these drugs, on a review, we found that most of these drugs are of little value. Yes, cimethicone has been used, then polyethylene glycol can be used, lubiprostone and linaclotide are used for chronic constipation in human beings, but they have little value in ruminants. Metoclopramide, levosulfuride, domperidone, sisapride did not have any significant effect on the contractility parameters of the rumen, right? These many reports say like this. And then the other drugs also have little value, or they have not been experimented and they have little value in the therapy of ruminal bloat, right? Then esophageal obstruction due to a foreign body leads to severe discomfort and acute free gas bloat. Physical removal of the object may be hampered by marked spasm of the surrounding muscle of the esophagus, and specific spasmolytic drugs such as acipromazine may be used, 0.05 to 0.1 mg per kg IM, IV or subcutaneous. Alternatively, the moderate sedative and muscle relaxant effects of a low dose of xylazine, 0.05 mg per kg intramuscular, or detomidine, 0.02 to 0.05 mg per kg intramuscular in cattle, may aid removal of the obstruction and easier passage of the stomach tube to relieve the animal from the obstruction, right? So this is all about the acute ruminal bloat, and if all this fails, one has to perform an emergency ruminotomy to save the life of the animal. Otherwise the animal will die, and one has to perform an emergency ruminotomy, right? So this is all about the acute ruminal tympany, or what we call the bloat. Hope we will discuss about the chronic ruminal tympany, or recurrent ruminal tympany, in a later class. If you wish that I continue to make more and more videos for you, kindly do subscribe to my channel. You can meet me at Instagram at @PurohitGN. You can mail me at gnpobs@gmail.com, and you kindly give your likes, give your comments, give your suggestions. And we have launched a app, the GNP Sir Classes. You can have plenty of free material, and you can have books, you can have plenty of free material on this app. Come to this app, download it, and then we have a lot of courses launched for different segments of veterinarians, and hope they will be useful. So have a nice time, enjoy learning with us, and do subscribe to our channel. Bye bye, all the best.